Do you know that you can heat or cool something with a magnet and a piece of metal? Let's try it. This tool can be used to move a magnet close to and away from a piece of metal. Watch through this thermal camera. When we move the magnet away from the metal, the temperature drops. Conversely, when we place it under the metal, the temperature increases. This phenomenon is valuable in producing liquid hydrogen, which is important for the development of a hydrogen economy. This is a typical example of cooling. Many of you know how it cools the air. Let's observe what's going on using a plastic bottle and a small air pump. Insert a plastic thermometer and screw on the pump. The temperature starts at 24 degrees centigrade. When we pump air into the bottle, compressing it, the temperature increases by 2 degrees. This principle can be used to heat air. In contrast, when we let the air out of the bottle, the temperature drops by 2 degrees. This is how air conditioners cool air. Why does the temperature of the air in the bottle change with the pressure? We know that the air molecules in the bottle are moving actively. As we push more air into the bottle, the molecules become more crowded, restricting their motion. The bottle releases excess energy equivalent to the reduction in the molecule's kinetic energy. Conversely, as we release the air, the remaining air molecules begin to move more, converting heat energy into kinetic energy. Thus, the bottle absorbs heat energy from its surroundings, cooling them. A similar phenomenon can be observed with this rubber balloon. When you stretch the balloon and release the tension, the temperature decreases. This is the mechanism responsible. When the balloon is stretched, its long molecules are pulled into alignment with the tension. Without the tension, the molecules are randomly ordered. This transition requires energy, which is absorbed from the balloon's surroundings. That's why the temperature decreases. Now let's think this over. What do the air-filled bottle and the balloon have in common? In both cases, the material absorbs heat from its surroundings, when its molecules go from a restricted to a free and random configuration. Now let's go back to the first scene. A piece of gadolinium metal and a powerful neodymium magnet. After stacking the two, remove the magnet suddenly. The temperature of the metal decreases. The temperature of the metal drops when we simply remove the magnet. This mechanism operates similarly to the previous cases. A gadolinium atom contains many rotating electrons. If a magnet is placed near the metal's electrons assume a uniform orientation. When the magnet is removed, they begin to rotate randomly. The metal absorbs heat from its surroundings when the electrons' rotations randomize. That's why its temperature drops. A material absorbs heat when its molecules go from an orderly to a random state. We at NIMS are focusing on this phenomenon to develop a technology called magnetic refrigeration. NIMS is working on this technology to cool hydrogen, enabling it to be stored and transported in a liquid state, contributing to the development of a hydrogen economy in the near future.